Welcome back to another Teardown video. Today we'll be diving into the internals of the latest iPhone 16, breaking it down step by step. You can also find links to the Teardown videos for the iPhone 16 Pro and iPhone 16 Pro Max in the video description below. Before we get started, let me show you the tools that I'll use for this Teardown: a screwdriver set, plastic pry tools, tweezers, a suction cup, and a screen disassembly tool. I've included links to all the tools in the video description below. Now, let's get started. The disassembly process starts by removing the two screws located near the charging port. Next, we'll remove the back glass. To do this, I'll heat the edges of the back glass with a regular hairdryer for about 2 minutes. If you're using a heat gun, set it to 90 degrees Celsius to soften the adhesive. This is a safe temperature for the back glass. Place the suction cup near the bottom edge, then insert a pry tool and carefully work your way around the edges. The adhesive is strong and might resist at first, but don't worry, just apply steady pressure. If needed, reheat the surface to help loosen the glue. At the top of the back cover, two metal loops secure the glass to the chassis. When opening this part, slide the pry tool downwards to help release the cover. Gently lift the back glass, being mindful of the cables that connect it to the logic board. With the metal bracket removed, we must disconnect the battery to ensure the device is completely powered down. The rear glass cover houses the wireless charging coil, a flashlight diode, and a rear microphone. One nice feature of the iPhone 16 is its removable back cover, making it easier to replace the glass if it cracks. Now, let's move on to the battery. Unlike previous models, the iPhone 16 no longer uses adhesive pull tabs. Instead, Apple has introduced an electrically induced adhesive, which requires a 9-volt battery and two wires with clamps for removal. Here's how you do it. Connect the black wire to the negative terminal and the red wire to the positive terminal of the 9-volt battery. Attach the black connector of the 9-volt battery to the lower right grounding screw on the bottom speaker. Peel off the small tab from the battery and attach the red connector of the 9-volt battery to the silver tab. It's important to ensure the metal clamps are in contact with both the grounding screw and the silver tab. Keep the connection for about 1 minute and 30 seconds to soften the adhesive. If the clamps disconnect, you'll need to start over. Using a suction cup, remove the battery from the iPhone housing. This method might be used in future iPhone models, so be prepared. And yes, you now need a battery to replace the battery. The iPhone 16's 3,561 mAh battery provides up to 22 hours of video playback, which is slightly larger than its predecessor, thanks in part to the power-efficient A18 chip. Apple might use electrically induced adhesive to help improve heat management. By bonding the battery more securely to the chassis, heat generated during charging or heavy use could dissipate more effectively, improving the overall performance and longevity of the battery. Next, let's see if Apple has made the charging port module easier to replace, as they did with the iPhone 16 Pro. But before, we need to remove some modules. The Taptic Engine, also known as the vibration motor, is compact yet effective. The loudspeaker module looks similar to previous models. The SIM card reader is still separate from the logic board, unlike the Pro version where it's integrated into the logic board. Unfortunately, the iPhone 16's charging port design remains the same, integrated with the lower microphone and other components, which complicates repairs. The Face ID module is composed of the front camera, dot projector, and infrared camera. The earpiece speaker is attached to the Wi-Fi antenna, which is glued to the assembly. The iPhone 16's camera module features a 48-megapixel main camera and a 12-megapixel ultra-wide camera, now shaped similarly to the iPhone X's module. The logic board is the last component remaining, but the display cables are still connected to the back of the board. It's safer to disconnect the display cables first before fully removing the logic board. Now, let's move on to removing the screen. I'll use a regular hairdryer to heat the edges of the display. If using a heat gun, set it to 80 degrees Celsius to soften the adhesive, which is safe for the iPhone's screen. Place the suction cup near the bottom edge of the screen and gently pull while sliding a spudger along the seam to loosen the adhesive. Removing the screen takes steady pressure, so be patient. Insert a plastic pry tool and carefully work around the edges. At the top of the screen, two metal loops secure the display module to the chassis. When opening this part, slide the pry tool downwards to help release the display. Once loosened, gently lift the screen, being mindful of the cables connecting it to the logic board. As with previous iPhones, a flexible cable with a sensor is glued to the display. You'll need to transfer this sensor if you replace the screen. Now, let's move on to the logic board. Next, we have the logic board, which houses the powerful A18 chip with a 6-core CPU, 5-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine. This board also includes 8GB of RAM, providing impressive performance for everything from high-end mobile gaming to advanced AI tasks. Finally, let's examine the control button. Interestingly, it's connected to the power button cable and seems to be welded to the chassis, making it nearly impossible to remove or replace without replacing the entire housing. If the chassis ever needs replacing, you'll likely need to find one that includes the control button. So, the iPhone 16 is completely disassembled and we can sum it up. I'm intrigued by Apple's new electrically induced adhesive for the battery. It's both a challenge and an innovation. The removable backglass is a definite plus for repairs, but the control button being welded to the chassis is a downside. I'd love to hear your thoughts. share them in the comments below. For more do-it-yourself repair guides on the iPhone 16, check out my playlist linked in the video description below. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and check out my other Teardown videos. See you next time.